Again today, my wonderful viewers. So we are going to be learning another interesting thing again, dealing with the hot cues. So you cannot write the story of DJing from the beginning to this point of the advancement of the DJ skills of every equipment without mentioning hot cues. So hot cues is an integral part of the DJing that you cannot ignore. So dealing with hot cues comes with a lot of technicality, especially when you start with dealing with the particular point of setting the hot cue of the song and a host of other features. So for the case of the virtual DJ, whether even on the aspect of the controller, you will need to understand that the hot cue is one of the major things. So it's after setting it to a particular point that you want the song to start from, you have to get it working, and the number of times at which you press it will determine how the sound will come into play. So a single press like this can make the song play continuously and allow it to grow. So there are three major things that when you are dealing with the hot cue. There is the hot in starting a song. So you start the song in a particular pattern. So you have the aspect where you deal with the hot cue, just starting the song and allowing it to play, dealing with placing it in the number of times to make it play. Or you have the situation where when you are dealing with it on the controller, you actually deal with it using the crossfader, where you take the crossfader off and bring it on. So in this aspect, this is how it will look like. So can you see this? This one is also starting the song, but this in this point is not just the hot cue, but it's actually a cue underscore play. That means you play it and stop it and start it from the beginning of the song again. Then you have the normal play. So the three ingredients here is you have the cue underscore play, you have the hot cue, then you have the normal play. So these three things work together. So the way you press it will determine how it gives you the kind of effect that you want. So but in this case, we are going to be dealing majorly with the hot cue, and then sometimes when you play around with this hot cue so much, you want to toggle it. That means switch from one track to another, just like beat grading. So for the case of the virtual DJ, it provided us with that easier transformation that you can just map our keys to get this result. So getting that, you need to set the keys that we are going to be dealing with, this letter H and then this W. These are the two keys we'll be dealing with. This one does the job of starting the song at a particular point based on the number of times you start it. This one is also a hot cue point, but the difference between this H and this W is this W will stop one of the deck from playing completely, then switch over to the other deck. Just like when you are doing it on the controller, when you are about starting one song, when you move the crossfader to the other side so that the song will just start. And although there is a mapping that this with this crossfader too, but that one is not too important for us because we don't want to be playing around with our crossfader. We just want to be playing around with the playing of the song and stopping it and then going to over to the other one. Let's see how it goes. This is it. This is it. This is Q underscore play. This is normal play. You just press it, it starts. No matter the number of times you press this, it will not give you the kind of effect that you want. Then this is the hot cue again now. So when you combine it with echo effect, then that is it. This is what you get. So I've explained this one. Then let's see how it goes. Let's see how this W will do the job for us. I'm going to be showing you the mapping, but let's see how it goes first. Let's start this beating. Let me set it at a particular cue point. Okay, I've set it. This is it. The song will start. Then let me take you to the other deck. So that is it. So it switches off from one deck to the other deck and stop it. So while we toggle the selector that moves us from deck A to deck B, from deck B back to deck A, let's see the mapping. So I've given so much explanation, so let's see the mapping. So while we go into the mapping to see it, you need to understand that when you are dealing with the virtual DJ software, you are actually dealing with commands, so instructions. So you first imagine the effect on your head, then you imagine the, how you do it on the normal controller, then you will now see how you can switch it to the keyboard. So it's very simple. The hot cue is just a normal hot cue that you know. Ignore these long phrases. These phrases, I just set them for my own personal use. There is a reason why I set it this way. This is the primary key of primary point of this, of the hot cue. Let me show you the major parts that does the job. This one, the rest of these keys, the rest of this mapping is just to turn off some things in the event, just to reset everything. So I will also leave it in the description, but this is the key thing here. This is it, the default hot cue. The highlighted one is the key thing, that the key command that does it. So we're actually telling the deck to play it at a particular hot cue one. So your hot cue one can be any point in the song, provided where you select. So anywhere you select it, that particular song to start the song will be your hot cue one. But if you don't want to use the hot cue one, you can use this particular command that I'm using, this letter U. This one takes care of selecting hot cue 7. So at the first point, whenever this a song is playing, if the hot cue is not set, once you press this particular letter U, it automatically sets a hot cue at that particular point. So I also use this sometimes to play around the song. So maybe I want to be flipping over a particular phrase, so you can use this too. Then you have your command where you can remove the hot cue, the inbuilt command that comes with the normal virtual DJ instruction, just the shift command and then that particular alphabet. Look at it, it automatically delete. This is delete Q underscore Q then 7. So it delete the Q point 7. So you can set Q point from very lot of phrases in the song based on your own choice. So that is for the hot cue one. That is for the hot cue one. That is letter H. I've highlighted it for you. Don't worry, it's going to be at the description box. I'll put it particularly there. Then you have your W. This is what the W do. You can see it. So it's a very simple command. The hot cue takes care of starting the song. That is the hot cue one. Then it automatically tells the deck that is active. That is the other deck that is active. That means it's being playing. It's playing, should stop. That is just the command that does it. So it's just like you are flipping over the next deck to the next deck and stopping the song from playing from the previous deck. Just like juggling from one track to another, or just stopping it and moving over. We are going to do it now. I'm going to put another different song on the beat, then you are going to see it in action. In this case, maybe you are playing one particular track, you just want to switch over immediately, you don't need to go through all those stress. So let me load the different track on it. In this case, let me get another track. So this is it. So the song is up. Let's start it now so that we can have a feel of it. So let's have a feel of it now. Let's go. Don't him say me mean pay home use. Mem padia will be a use. Don't him say me mean. So you can see how I'm able to switch from one track to another without any stress. Just one or two keys doing the job for me. One click, and that's all. So let's continue to enjoy it. This is it. Let's go back to it so that I see it again. So I didn't show you the action in the key. So this is it. So the song is actually playing. Look at it, letter W. Look at it. It will automatically flip over to the next track now. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't him say me mean pay home use. So thank you very much. Keep a date and continue to enjoy yourself. I'm sure you've learned something today again. So that is how I'm going to be giving you more and more. Sorry this video came a bit late. I'm sure you really learned something. So keep a date as we continue to learn more. Let's fire on Mr. DJ. Yeah.